Hi, I'm STS-131 Mission Specialist Stephanie Wilson, and you are watching NASA TV.
Discovery, and a special good morning for Stephanie.
Good morning, Houston. I'd like to thank my parents, Barbara and Eugene, for selecting that song. It certainly is a stairway to the stars up here. We're having a great time, and we're looking forward to another great day and another great EVA.
Airlock for EVA. We had two good leak checks. We're complete with EVA prep going to India Purge.
Airlock Houston, we copy two good leak checks going to Purge.
Quest airlock is back to the 14.7 pounds per square inch, and as you can see, the hatch to the Quest airlock between the rest of the station coming open.
And Houston airlock for step 9 and EMU purge. We picked up the purge at 04:01:15.
Houston copies 04:01:15.
They copy.
Here's some sequential still video shots being sent down from the space shuttle through its S-band antenna. As you can see, the robotic arm making its way to the S1 segment of the truss where Anderson and Nastracchio are working. It was moved overnight into position on the robotic arm's mobile base system, which allows it to move up and down the truss.
I'm going to have you put your ret to the ammonia tank handrail.
That system is also where the new ammonia tank assembly is currently stored, ready to be moved into the old ammonia tank assembly spot once it's been removed. The ammonia tank assemblies provide ammonia to the station's radiators, which help it cool the station systems, keep them from overheating.
Just like you called it.
Seeing our first video of the spacewalk, just in time for the crew members to begin handing over the ammonia tank assembly to the robotic arm, is the view from Mission Specialist Clay Anderson's helmet cam.
More turns just for fun.
And there's the end effector of the robotic arm ready to take that ammonia tank assembly once it's released.
How long till sunrise? Okay, let's push this end down and see if I can get it. Bolt one's good and free. Yeah, bolt two's still hanging on. Yeah, dog it. Go, George. Now. Is your end up, or how, where's your end right now?
My end looks, well, my bolt
kind
one's
of right
place.
Bolt one's still in place.
Yeah.
Get a good idea of the ammonia tank assembly size from this view. And in the center of the screen is the handle that the space station's robotic arm is going to use to hold onto it.
A discovery for EVA, that bolt 2 also has a soft dock feature that may be hanging up.
Yeah, we know.
Oh, yeah.
Rich, if you can give me a call on the arm so I make sure I don't.
I can't see you where my position right now.
Yeah, we can see it in your well clear, Clay. They're far back. You're not going to hit them unless you, like, did a complete pitch.
Okay.
Spacewalker's having a little trouble getting all the bolts to completely release the ammonia tank assembly, so they're going to move into their backup plans for that and grab a pry bar to use and help help get it the rest of the way out of place on the S1 truss segment.
Yeah, Rick has that concern, though. He doesn't want it to pop too far up.
If you do, just be careful, Claire.
Yeah, I got a good hand on it.
Okay.
So here we go with a couple. Oh, yeah.
There we go.
I'm really getting good at this.
Okay. Stephanie right. Fox is your hero.
I love that girl, and she's an Iowa Stater. Okay.
All right.
So it's nice and clear, Rick. So apparently.
Can you get back in position while I hold it?
Yes.
Okay.
Go ahead. Yeah, just. Are you comfortable?
I'm okay. Yeah,
it's going to take me a minute.
Take your time.
Clay.
Oh, thanks. This one was way easier.
Yeah, I'm really glad we didn't have to go for that pry bar.
You're glad.
Yeah, I know.
And last of the bolts has come free with the help of some juggling by Clay Anderson, and now they're getting ready to move that ammonia tank assembly to the space station's robotic arm.
Yeah. All right, two white lines are visible. I got a hand back on.
Okay, you ready to lift up?
Let me lock my ERCOM. Okay, or my ECOM. Okay.
Yeah, got your visor down?
Yeah, visor down.
All right, nice and easy. 2 feet.
Let's see what we can do.
Moving?
I got mine on.
Both sides look like they're moving. Easy. Tell me when you no longer have reach.
Oh, I got a little bit more yet.
Okay, well, that's about. Isn't it?
Looks like 2 feet to me.
Stephanie, what do you think?
Rick and Clay, we like it. If it's comfortable for you to hold it.
It is. Got it, Rick.
Got it. All
right. I
understand we're, you're ready for grapple.
Ready for grapple.
Okay, I'm hands off, Dottie.
Here again is some sequential still video being sent down through the shuttle's S-band antenna. At the top center of the screen is Mission Specialist Clay Anderson holding the ammonia tank assembly with the handle, the power data grapple fixture. Mission Specialist Stephanie Wilson and Pilot Jim Dutton at the controls of the robotic arm and the Destiny Laboratory at the robotic workstation.
Triggering on my mark, 2-1 mark.
How's that grapple look? Beautiful. Okay, because it's good, pretty good motion over here. They're all over it. All right.
And the SSRMS has the tank.
Excellent. Thank you. Houston, no pitbanes are loose.
And Houston copies. Thanks, Clay.
The spacewalkers will now be making their way to the seated cart, and that's the crew equipment translation aid cart, where they'll be tying the old ammonia tank assembly down for a little while.
Back in the bag.
Working it.
Copy that. And Clay, your next thing is going to be to get that bag.
Okay.
And Rick and Clay, verify that you're ready for release?
Ready.
Ready.
Copy that. Releasing on my mark. 2-1, mark.
Mission Specialist Stephanie Wilson there reporting that she and Jim Dutton are going to let go of the old ammonia tank assembly now, or have let go of it, with the station's robotic arm and are moving away. And a video look at the ammonia tank assembly on the crew equipment and translation end cart, with spacewalkers on either end of it tightening down the straps that they've installed.
And it feels very steady and sturdy, Dottie.
Yeah, it looks really stable from where I'm at, too. And on your side, Rick, I'll take some WVS survey.
Okay. You see that? On top, which helmet, which light are your camera on?
And let's see, if I can have you maybe tilt your head back a little bit, just with the lower lighting, it's a little difficult to see. Okay, yeah, I can see that. That looks great.
Be good, Clay, working on the other one there.
Yep, I can see him.
Pick your hand up a little, Clay, your right hand.
Hey, Clay, I can see yours, and that looks really good and really stable with those two in daisy chain. Thanks.
Seeing this view of both ammonia tank assemblies, the old one in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, and the space station robotic arm moving towards the new one, which is stored temporarily on its mobile base system, the rail car that allows the arm to move up and down the shuttle's truss.
Yeah, and I mean, I feel like from my vantage point, I can see.
There they are.
That looks good.
Also a good view of Rick Mastracchio in that view with the red stripes on his spacesuit.
Okay, good work.
That designates his status as the lead spacewalker for the mission. Spacewalkers Anderson and Mastracchio are working their way towards the P1 segment of the station's truss. They're going to be installing two radiator grapple fixture stowage beams on this segment of the station's truss that would be used temporarily to store handles that would be needed if a radiator on the station ever needed to be replaced.
Did it work as planned?
It looks like it's going to, but let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Anderson and Mastracchio will be installing two more of these stowage beams on the starboard side of the station's truss during their third spacewalk.
Yeah, just hand it to me, whatever's easiest, Clay. I'll try to figure it out, or Dottie will tell me how to figure it out. I got it. So, Dottie.
View here from Mission Specialist Rick Mastracchio's helmet camera. You can also see Anderson on the left-hand side of the screen in his view.
Station forward with a tether point.
Okay, I'm going to work on a socket swap, Dottie. Yeah.
Each of these stowage beams is held in by two bolts, which Mastracchio is going to be driving in.
You ready for PGP?
Ready.
Bravo 1. Clockwise.
While this is going on over on the port segment of the truss, on the starboard side, the team here on the ground is reporting that the space station robotic arm officers have managed to remove the new ammonia tank assembly from the arm's mobile base system. They'll now be heading it towards the S1 segment of the truss where the old one was installed.
Okay, Clay, it's right over your... right off the top of your back there. You're good right where you are, okay? You'll start to see it coming in. Good clearance, Jim. Continue. Here. Oh. Right there. Yep.
This, again, is going to provide the starboard radiators for the station ammonia to help keep systems on the station cool. Spacewalker Rick Mastracchio is going to be holding the ammonia tank assembly down for a few moments once the robotic arm lets go, and then he and Clay Anderson are going to be driving in four bolts to hold it in place.
Alpha 7, right?
Clock. Alpha 7, clockwise 2.
Alpha 7. Clockwise 2. It's not turning. The PGT is trying. But the bolt's not turning. Breaking torque. Okay. right, he'll go to the crib sheet. He'll give you a different setting.
Yeah, just a sec.
Bolt 4 is not engaged in the soft dock. Right, we understand. So we're saying it lets you hold it down, and I'll go to bolt 2, and then we'll try to get bolt 4 down.
Okay. I'm in a good spot here, I think.
Copy. I see you in a good spot.
Check with Houston, buddy.
Do you think it goes with your plan?
Okay, I'm popping out of the APFR. I'm going to go get bolt 2.
Bolts on the ammonia tank assembly, giving the spacewalkers a little bit of trouble as they are trying to get them all engaged the correct amount. This is going to hold the new ammonia tank assembly onto the S1 segment of the station's truss. Truss, of course, is the basically the backbone of the station, which provides the structural support for things like the solar arrays and the radiators, which the ammonia tanks are going to be providing ammonia to. Crews trying to make sure that the ammonia tank assembly is in exactly the right place and see if that's maybe why the bolts aren't turning quite as well as they should. If that doesn't work, the crew here on the team here on the ground is ready with some advice to help them try a few other troubleshooting mechanisms.
Discovery for EVA, we think hard impulsive force on top of the clevis bracket might help.
All right, Rick, let me do a quick move. And, that was pretty impulsive. I didn't do anything. I think they're frozen. Oh, stop.
Specialist Clay Anderson still having problems getting his two bolts driven, so he's going to go back to the Quest airlock and pick up some more tools so that he can try a few different methods of getting it into place so that it can be driven all the way.
Just tell me where you are, Clay.
I'm a bolt 4.
Okay.
Alpha 7 clockwise 2.
lines on Bolt 4.
Copy, I'll stand. You hear that, Clay?
Yeah, stand by that. I'm going to need to hear the Delta.
Sure, no problem.
Now that they think they've got the troublesome bolt seated, they're going to see if they can go ahead and tighten it down before working with the other bolts, the four bolts, and all that hold the ammonia tank assembly to the S1 truss.
Now that the old ammonia tank has been lifted off of the CETA cart, that's the crew equipment translation aid cart, and is being moved away by the station's robotic arm, both Mastracchio and Anderson are working on securing some brake handles on this particular part of the station.
Go ahead, Sam.
Yeah, Dottie, when Clay gets ahead here, page 7-76, his step 26 has him translate to ESP2. What we'd like is, instead of that, when he gets there, to send him back to page 7-74, Rick's step 74, which basically will send Clay back around to pick up Rick's APFR and then bring it around the front and stick it on the CETA cart. Now, copy.
I copy and understand.
Okay, you can explain it to me in a couple minutes. Yeah.
I will. I got it.
Rick Mastracchio and Clay Anderson are installing an adjustable grapple bar, much like what they did during the first spacewalk. And this is basically just a tool that helps them move the ammonia tank around a little bit easier. These ammonia tanks are quite large.
While passing through calibration.
And they have quite a bit of mass to them, even though they are weightless in space, they still have the full mass, so they have to be very careful how they move them around.
Okay. Check the CETA card coupler is still in capture.
It is.
Push the inboard brake release 2 times.
It is.
Couple the CETA card to the MT slowly.
Slowly? Okay. How's that pull operation doing?
They have the arm just stable behind you. They're not moving it.
Okay.
So you have plenty of clearance, no factor at all.
Okay, good.
And EVA and Houston, the big loop, we are starting motion on the arm.
And we copy, and Rick will be out of your way momentarily.
Thanks, Daddy. It's mainly just a wrist cluster motion. We are in the step 24.
Okay, Rick. Once the CETA cart is in the coupler, take it to lock.
It's there.
Lock it. And if you can just give us a little bit of WBS survey of the brake handles, they'd like that.
Hey, brake handles. Daddy, CETA cart, crew lock bag is on board. I'm leaving the CETA cart.
Okay, and if you look off to your right shoulder, you can see the work of your ammonia tank coming into view.
All right, I'm going to try to get out of the way before I look.
Yeah, you're out of the way. They're about 6 feet.
Okay, good. I'm worried.
2 meters.
Yeah.
So you are good to go in and to close this up as a thermal cover.
Everything okay? You can conclude. The Velcro strap comes where?
The feed comes inside, there's a little tab there.
Yeah. Okay. There it is.
Nice job.
Alright.
We started the morning in the airlock. This is Trace Caldwell and Jim Dutton helping Rick and Clay get into their suits and get into the airlock. And here's TJ getting our safers ready. TJ was also a great help today. And, of course, Dottie, she loaded us up with tools and put us to work as soon as we got out the door. These safers are backpacks that they're donning right now on the spacesuit, and those allow us that if we were to fall off in some strange event, we could fly back. And the way they put us into the airlock after they put the safers on is the first person to go out the door goes in head first, and the second person goes in feet first, and then we spend a little bit of time as we wait for the pressure to go down and to be ready to open the hatch. We fiddle with our tools and we just try to get comfortable and relax a little bit before we head outside to do our EVA, and you see how many people it takes to stuff us all in there. A lot of work and effort and pre-planning goes into EVAs also. This is Stephanie and Naoko in the MPLM, you know, and they're doing simultaneous operations, trying to do a lot of resupply and return supply work. And really, really busy. This is Rick coming out of the airlock. I'm sorry, this is Clay coming out of the airlock and on EVA 2.
And at the beginning, the crew members, each EV crew member puts on a safety tether. It's sort of like a leash. You can think of it that way. And that way, they're always connected to station and we don't have to worry about them getting hurt. And there you see Rick coming out of the airlock. And so now we have both EVA crew members outside. And we do a couple safety checks to make sure those tethers are on good and solid. And then we also make sure that the safer that we talked about, that their handles are both down. And that means that if they needed to, they could use their jetpack and fly themselves back to station. But that would be in a worst-case scenario. And Jim and I were at the robotics workstation today, getting the arm into position and working with Rick and Clay with the ammonia tank. They did a fine job again, holding it steady for us as we did a couple of grapples and a couple of releases, but the operations went very well today.
Yeah, today was just a stellar example of great teamwork. We had Stephanie and Jim on the arm, Rick and Clay outside, Dottie on the flight deck, front of the whole show, and with lots of communication, lots of practice, lots of teamwork, and a lot of help from the ground, with a lot of great planning and a year of training, they were able to execute the plan really well. This is on the CETA cart on the truss of the space station, and CETA is a crew equipment translation aid, and they were preparing this CETA cart at a temporary storage place for the ammonia tank that was going to come out of the truss on the backside. And they just handed that tank off to Stephanie and Jim on the arm, and then the old tank was going to be placed temporarily on this CETA cart while they took the new tank and took it off of the payload attach mechanism on the mobile base system and took it across and placed it in a truss. Okay, here we are working on the CETA cart some more. Basically, what we had to do is to tie the old CETA cart down with six different tethers, and that kind of structurally made it sound so that in case we had to leave it overnight, but luckily we're able to get it off and store it in a more permanent location in the PO, POA. And here we are getting ready to work with the arm folks on one of those ammonia tanks. One of the things that was interesting today and unique for both Rick and I was the fact that we were on the backside of the truss a lot for the station, and we found that the extremes of hot temperature and cold temperature were quite pronounced compared to our previous EVAs. I'm sure we'll be able to find out exactly why that is. We have an idea, but we'll see.
This is a view inside the laboratory module at the robotics workstation. Jim and I were hard at work flying the arm and trying to do our best to keep it steady as we were either going over the pin or coming off of the pin for Rick and Clay, and they were holding it steady for us. And now we're back in the MPLM with the Miracle doing transfer.
Today we installed two experiments. One is Glacier, which is a freezer on a space station, and also the thermal research facility. And because we are doing supply and return items in parallel, so sometimes we have to go behind the rack because we have stored, you know, lots of items behind the rack. So we have to rotate the rack and get items, and so lots of supplies and return items done today.
This is Stephanie and Jim again at the robotics workstation. They took turns flying the arm and helping and doing the M2 task, or the helping task. And there's always, of course, time for a little camaraderie and meal. And this is back in the Russian segment in the service module. And we have three Russian cosmonauts on board. And there you have Suichi, Oleg Kotov, TJ Kramer, Naoko, Michelle Kornienko, Alexander Strochkov.
They have a great time in the SM. The SM's a great place to have meals and hang out. And Fyodor Yurchikhin, when I was on board Expedition 15, one of the greatest times on a space mission is the time that you can take to fellowship and have meals and play with your food and just like Suichi's doing. If you look at the bubbles closely, of course, it's also amusing our crew, too. But when you are on station, you got a lot of time to play with your food, and it's finally okay.
This is Naoko Yamazaki, who is an absolute machine when it comes to transfer. And today she's right there installing the Glacier into the lab rack. And these are large freezers that we brought up, and she installed one of those today. This is Naoko again inside the MPLM, and you can see that it's chock full of resupply racks and storage bags, and Naoko's having a great time doing it. She's really a pro at it.
sometimes you just have to appreciate the beauty around you. And here you can see our windows on the shuttle, and we're looking at the GEM module, and we're looking at the arm moving the ammonia tank into place for the EVA crew members, Clay and Rick, to actually, looks like this time they're going to untie it down so it can move. And this was part of our detailed choreography for Earth and that fragile little atmosphere around it. Our activities today were very varied, but very team-oriented with all the transfer work that's going on, all of the EVA and together and to train us. It was absolutely a fantastic day, and topped off by some spectacular views.
This was amazing. I parked myself in the commander's window, and it was just marvelous to watch Rick and Clay outside along the truss assembly, and with Jim and Stephanie moving the arm. It was just absolutely breathtaking, and it really capped off a great year of training. This is Jim Dutton opening the airlock hatch when Clay and Rick coming inside after their almost 7.5-hour EVA. And just like when we put them into the hatch, they come back inside, and it's amazing when you open the hatch right after the EVA. There's a very distinctive scent that we like to call the smell of space, and it's very distinctive, and it's very hard to describe, but it's definitely repeatable. Here's the hatch coming open, and you'll see Rick and Clay coming out here in just a second. Yeah, here Jim's taking us out. Jim and Tracy are taking us out of the airlock. They did a great job. We pretty much started the EVA prep, I think, on time, but we ended up going out the door almost an hour early. So I'm not sure how they did that, but they were fantastic at getting us out the door. And, of course, even after the 7.5-hour spacewalk, and it was a lot of fun, you sure are ready to get out of your spacesuit and get some food. And they, of course, were great getting us out quick so we could get some food in us. The process of bringing us inside is basically the reverse of the process of taking us outside, so except for the fact that we really want to get out quick because we are, as Rick said, hungry and ready for some cleanup and things. So it's also a great choreography lesson again. You know, everybody doing their job, everybody doing something separate, but all of it together makes it very effective. And you see us passing things back and forth. You know, somebody reads a step, and then they do the step, and then somebody looks at the book and checks it off. So it's really great to have a team like this that works so well together. And of course, there's Mr. Mastracchio waving to all his fans in Waterbury, Connecticut. Here's Clay back inside. Just a great day for Clay. He worked really hard, got a lot done, and overcame a couple of challenges, and those guys just did a great job. You can see that really tiring work. They've been in the suits for 8-plus hours, and they're ready for a well-deserved break and a rest.
So once we got the guys back inside, we're continuing with our transfer operations. Today, one of the things on our timeline was to transfer a temporary sleep station. This is sort of the early version of crew quarters, and we brought up a crew quarters in our logistics module. The advanced version of the crew quarters has a comm, so you can hear caution and warning tones. It's noise insulated. It has computer access, so it's much more comfortable than the early version. So we're packing up the earlier version and taking it home with us in the MPLM.
Again, you can see how effortless it really is to move large objects. They obviously have mass, and sometimes they're difficult to get moving and difficult to stop moving. But once you do get them moving, they're relatively easy to move through the station. inches as you go, but one person can move several hundred pounds of gear relatively easy. And that's all we had for you this evening. I hope you enjoyed it.
Good afternoon. This is Mission Control Houston. We have joined the planning team here in the space.